ASIO, audio stream input slash output. So that's what it stands for, but what does it do and should you get it? Well, that all depends. And in this video, I'm going to look at reasons why you might want to get it, reasons why you might not want to get it. And if your audio interface doesn't have its own ASIO driver, I'll tell you how you can get one for it. Now, first, let's look at a reason why you might not want to get ASIO on your system. It's if you're a Mac user. If you're a Mac user, you don't need ASIO and it's not even available to you. And that's because you have a far superior audio system called Core Audio. So be super happy about that. But if you're a Windows user and you want to get into music production, ASIO is pretty much a must-have, in my opinion anyway. And here's one reason why. Your latency will be much lower. And if you plan on recording to a click track, a drum beat, or any other instrument, you should really get ASIO so you can time whatever you're playing or singing along with whatever's playing back on your computer. And that's because ASIO bypasses many layers of the Windows Direct Sound API, which all of your audio is routed through on a Windows system. And if that's not enough reason to get ASIO, then consider this. If you have an audio interface that has more than two inputs and you want to access those extra inputs, then you'll need ASIO so you can access more than just input one and two. Now coming up, I have another reason why you might want to get ASIO, but first I want to look at another reason why you wouldn't want to get it. If you're primarily recording into the Audacity software and you haven't compiled the code yourself to add the ASIO capabilities, then you won't really be able to use ASIO anyway, as the Audacity that you download from their website and the one that pretty much everybody uses doesn't have ASIO capabilities built into it. Even though Audacity can use it, they just don't have the license to use it yet. So if you use Audacity and it's just the one directly from their website, ASIO may not be for you. However, I have heard from many people who have installed the ASIO driver for their audio interface and still use Audacity to record, and they say the recording quality is much better after installing the ASIO driver, even though Audacity doesn't use it. That may be true, it may not be true, but it is something that I've heard from several people. Now, here's another reason why you might want to use ASIO. It gives you the direct output. If you use the Windows Direct Sound, you're actually getting a compressed version of the output signal, but with ASIO, you're getting the complete full output of your audio directly to your audio interface. It's not compressed or anything like that. So there's another pro for using ASIO. Now let's look at how you can get ASIO for your audio interface, even if your audio interface doesn't have its own driver for it. You can use ASIO for All, and this is an emulated ASIO driver, and it allows you to even route audio in different ways. So you could have multiple audio interfaces, multiple USB mics, and outputting to an audio interface or to a sound card. You can really route audio however you want, and you get access to the ASIO standard that's going to bypass those layers of Windows Direct Sound. So using ASIO for All is better than not using an ASIO driver at all for music production. Now check out how to install and set up ASIO for All by clicking the video on the screen. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Audio Tech TV, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.